can't buy happiness, but it can buy a yacht. And sailing in a yacht makes me happy. You can do the math. There's nothing to unclutter your mind than getting away in an open expanse of ocean. It's a complete change of perspective. And if you're sailing in a yacht like this one, then adventure is just a matter of course. A yacht is a recreational boat. The term originated from the Dutch word meaning hunt. It was originally defined as a light, fast sailing vessel used by the Dutch Navy to pursue pirates and other transgressors around and into the shallow waters of the Low Countries. Evolution, as they say, has made the yacht a luxury from a necessity. Yacht lengths generally range from 27 feet up to hundreds of feet. A luxury craft smaller than 40 feet is more commonly called a cabin cruiser or simply cruisers. A mega yacht generally refers to any yacht above 100 feet, and a super yacht generally refers to any yacht over 200 feet. Many different kinds of yachts, many options. But before you set out to sea, there is a certain amount of sailing expertise that you have to have. And I'm in good hands today because I'm sailing with Shakil. Hi Shakil, welcome to the show.
Hi.
So along with being the man behind Aquasail, Shakil is also the first Indian ever to win a gold on international waters in sailing. How long have you been sailing for?
Well, from the age of 10, which is almost 4 decades now.
My God, that's a lot of expertise handling this boat today.
Yes, I think I've spent almost all my life on the water, every bit of holiday, every bit of time. These waters are known with the back of my hand here.
What a life that is. So tell me, Shakil, this particular boat, what type of a yacht is it?
Well, this is an ocean-going yacht. Therefore, it can go out to sea for extended durations. It can be out on the water, crossing an ocean for over a couple of weeks.
My God, sounds exciting. So tell me, is it only a sailing boat or do you also back it up with a motor engine?
The engines are largely used to be able to go out of the harbour and enter harbour, and maybe when the wind is very light and you need to use it a bit. Mm-hmm. But you don't need an engine to really sail this boat.
So sailing is relatively new in India, or say sailing gaining the kind of popularity that is new. So when you bring the sailboat to the country, do you make changes to it? Have you customized it to suit the country's needs?
Yes, each boat has a specialization. This is of course a holiday boat. It's a brand Leopard, which is the foremost holiday brand in the world. Mm-hmm. And so there are a lot of customization we have done even for India in terms mm-hmm. of we have put a solar panels, because mm-hmm. here the sun is there and we can use those to charge the batteries. Mm-hmm. And the lack of infrastructure, mm-hmm. like no marinas, where you don't have any shore power, mm-hmm. these are some of the things we need to do to make it independently handle the boats.
Okay, so say you've got the boat. Mm-hmm. And if a person wanted to set out and be a sailor, how long would it be before I could set sail?
Well, you need about 20 to 25 hours of sailing to be able to take a boat out yourself independently.
Oh, great. So I can actually clock that in, say, a week?
You can clock it in a week, but long-term learning sets in with a little bit of gaps in between the courses you do.
Yeah. Okay, so that's sailing as a sport. But, you know, we're talking about sailing as a lifestyle as well. And for you, of course, it has been literally a lifestyle. What do you make of that?
Well, most people use sailing as probably adventure or as a sport. So there are different facets to it. Holiday lifestyle like this boat, it's a platform. It's a very big platform. It has got everything you need. Families can spend time. For example, you could go to Lakshadweep for a diving holiday. And you don't really need anybody. You can yourself sail it from here and enjoy the entire holiday living on the boat.
Wow, that sounds really exciting. And I believe that apart from living on a boat and taking a holiday, you could also find true love, isn't it?
Well, I did. Sailing has been, it's been a lot of things for me. And one is, of course, I met my wife because of sailing.
How lovely. So it was some years ago, I had just started sailing, and of course I met Shakil at various sailing events and was fascinated by what he'd achieved. And one day Shakil, you know, we've all heard about romance on the sea, and it actually happened to me. I just can't believe it yet. love is in the air and we are far out at sea, but there's a lot going on behind the wheel to keep this fairy tale afloat. So I'm going to take some time to talk technology with the captain. Hi.
Hello. Welcome aboard.
Thank you. So this is Captain Oscar.
Hello.
And this is his throne where he pilots this craft from.
Yep.
Thank you for letting me share it for a while.
That's my pleasure.
So that's a really interesting big gadget out there. What is it?
That's called the electronic chart. This is the GPS location of our boat, as well as the other objects on the sea. Mm-hmm. So what we do basically is, according to the course to steer, we set our course onto this electronic chart.
Okay.
And then we track our position on the Earth according to the positions that we want to go to.
Okay, mm-hmm. So it's a GPS, except it's global and for the ocean.
Exactly, yeah. Exactly.
Okay,
yeah.
And the three dials in front over here?
Those are what we call the tri-data. This is the depth, our speedo ground, and the heading.
Okay.
This is
ocean depth under the boat?
Yeah, that's the depth underneath the water level of our boat.
Okay, so it tells me the depth of the ocean where
exactly,
I am.
Exactly.
So you've got a radar or a sonar underneath?
There's a solar system. It sends the echo signals to the seabed and then picks them back up. So it calculates, it measures the distance between us and the seabed.
Cool. Okay, so we're 33.6 feet deep right now?
Exactly.
Ah, okay, that sounds safe now.
That is good in Hamburg.
And that over there?
That is the wind indicator.
Okay.
We have a wind indicator at the top of the mast, and then it goes to show the strength of the wind and also the direction of the wind.
Which is one of your most important monitors on a sailboat?
Exactly, exactly. Because this is a sailboat, we really want to know where the wind comes from so that we set our sails accordingly and we make the speed, we set the optimum speed according to this gauge.
So the old weather vane with a cock-a-doodle is out, I'm guessing.
Yeah.
That's what we graduated to.
Exactly.
And that's a very fancy looking compass.
Yeah, it's our compass. We have an electronical compass as well as a mechanical one. And this is always a good idea to have more than a few compasses on a boat because this is designed for long trips.
Mm-hmm.
It actually came all the way from Cape Town.
Okay.
So it's really a good idea not to have only one compass. So we have a digital one and as well as a mechanical one. That's that one.
Cool. And that over there is the autopilot, right?
Exactly. That's okay. My coolest thing. I really like pushing this on and off. You know, when you're busy doing something else, you just push the button and then it controls the boat and then it sails the boat according to the direction, according to the heading that you put on onto the autopilot, so that you can deal with other things on the boat.
Okay, so do you actually feed in your course every time you're heading out? Do you manually have to feed it in for it to take on autopilot, or it's an automated sort of setting?
It depends on your decision. If you know where you want to go, then what you can do actually, you can set the course, feed in the data according to your waypoints.
Mm-hmm.
For example, you want to go to Manduar and then to Elephanta afterwards. So the heading towards Manduar is something like 145 degrees.
Mm-hmm.
So I put 145 and then I calculate the distance. So it takes me to Manduar in say 10 miles. And then after 10 miles, I can set this up to turn my heading towards the Elephanta. So I can do that.
Mm-hmm.
Or alternatively, I can just manually set the course and push auto, and then it will take me to the course that I've set manually on the helm station.
So it will take the readings from your manual course and then
exactly.
set themselves.
Exactly.
Ah, that's cool.
Yeah, it is.
Okay,
it?
So I just need to steer it right and then turn auto and it'll just
that's
keep
it.
Me going right.
That's it, exactly.
Okay, that's a neat little gadget.
Let's
work.
We also have those electronical winches.
Mm-hmm.
What we do is, in order to hoist a sail, for example, we turn it around the winch.
Right.
And then there is this nice button again that you need to use your toe. So if you push it, it automatically starts spinning. And once it's spinning, then it pulls the rope. So it's pretty nice and easy.
Oh, well, so you're on a sailboat, but you're not really dealing with any of the, you know, the ropes and trying to get out of the way because the mast is going to come swinging. It's all electronic now.
Exactly.
And this, of course, is your wheel, right?
Yep, that's the steering wheel.
and these gears right here?
Those are my gears, my throttles. Those are my engines. I've got one engine on the port, one engine on the starboard, and those are independently controlled from those handles. Mm-hmm. If you push it forward, the boat goes forward. If you, this is on neutral, and it goes backwards. So this is easy as this.
Okay, so I've listened to everything you've said very intently. Okay. Do you think you trust me enough to leave me with the wheel for a while?
Well, we shall see.
Oh,
why
yeah?
don't you, yeah, why
okay.
don't you give it a go?
Okay.
Okay, it's yours.
Thank you. And I know he hasn't pressed the autopilot. So this is all me. So sailing is obviously not all fun and games, at least not for the guys behind the wheel manning all of this gadgetry. But thanks to them, for you and me at least, it's fair weather all the way. So sit back.